गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो एज़ यू कैन सी टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यूनिट फोर्थ, दैट इज़ माई कंट्री. ऑल राइट, एंड इन यूनिट फोर फर्स्ट सेक्शन इज, सेक्शन ए इज अ नेशंस स्ट्रेंथ, दैट वॉट इज़ द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ अ नेशन ऑफ अ कंट्री. सो द पोयम इज अबाउट दैट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ अ कंट्री. ओके, हु इज कॉल्ड द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ अ कंट्री. So what do you think makes a nation great? Name some people who make you feel proud of your country. All right, now let's start the poem. Okay, so before starting this poem, I want to give an introduction. Okay, so the poem A Nation's Strength by William Ralph Emerson is the form of rhetorical questions. Okay, here some questions are asked, okay, to us, and finally the poet's conclusion regarding what nation's strength is and what is not. The poem has been divided into 6 stanzas. So we can see here 1 2 3 4 5 6, 6 stanzas we can see. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. The poem is divided into 6 stanzas having 4 lines each. 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. All right, the rhyme scheme of the poem is ABAB, that we will see. Now let's start the poem. What makes, and this poem is written by again William Ralph Emerson. Who is the poet? William Ralph Emerson. All right. What makes a nation's pillars high and its foundation strong? What makes it mighty to defy the foes that round it throngs? Okay, so foes, the enemy. Okay, throng, वो जो जिसे हम बोलेंगे ना एक राजगद्दी, that is throng. All right, so first of all we will see the rhyming scheme. Pillar high, one, A, strong, B, high, defy, again A, strong, strong, throng, B. So rhyming scheme we have seen here, rhyming scheme is ABAB. All right, now what is given in stanza 1? In this stanza there is a comparison with a building. The poet simply asks the readers in the rhetoric way. Rhetoric way means he is asking a question. Okay, what makes a nation's pillars high and its foundation strong, and what makes it mighty, that is strong enough. Okay, what makes it mighty means very strong. What makes a nation very strong to defy or to resist the foes? Foes means enemies. Okay, enemies. All right, that found that round it throng, or those who gather around to damage. The foes that around the throng means those who are gathered around to damage a nation. So who are they, the people? All right, so this is the question is asked here. Now next, it is not gold, its kingdoms grand go down in battle shock, its shafts are laid on sinking sand, not an on abiding rock. So let's start. So in stanza 2, the poet answers himself, that he is asking a question and he is giving an answer here. Okay, in this stanza the poet answers himself that it is neither materialistic things. Okay, so it is not gold. Gold is what? A material thing. It is not a materialistic thing which makes a nation strong. Okay, its kingdoms grand go down in battle shock. Okay, so what the poet is saying here, neither the materialistic things nor money that makes the nation's kingdom grand. Okay, this is not, these are not the things which makes a nation strong. A country that is rich and has ample of resources is always prone to attacks from outsider. Thus, its foundation lays on sinking sands rather than abiding rocks. Okay, so this is the answer here. All right, it is not the gold, not the material things which makes a nation strong. Now next, is it the sword? Asked the red dust of empires passed away. The blood again, rhyming scheme A B A B. All right, is it the sword? Asked the red dust of empires passed away. The blood has turned their stones to rust, their glory to decay. Yes. So in third stanza, the poet raises another rhetorical question. Again, he is asking a question. Is it the sword? Sword is representing here power. Okay. Now ask the red dust of empires passed away. Okay. So what he is saying here, that he asked whether it is the sword which makes a nation great. Swords here stands for power, I told. Okay. The poet asks us to look into the past. Okay, here he is asking us to look into the past and see the big empires whose foundation was led on blood and power. So led on blood and power, so this is not the power actually, this is not which makes a nation strong. So power is not that which makes a nation strong. All right, so according to the poet, what he is saying here, the blood which was shed for the kingdoms has turned their stones to rust and their glory to decay. Matlab bilkul khatam ho jana, just because they were laid on the blood of the innocent people. Hence, power is also not something that makes a nation great. So, material thing is not that makes a nation great. Okay. Power is not that thing that makes a nation great. Okay. So, now let's see what is given. Next, and is it bright? Oh, that bright crown has seemed to nations sweet, but God has struck its luster down in ashes at his feet. Very important. Okay, so in stanza 4, he wonders if it is the pride. Okay, he's talking here about the pride. Okay, if it is the pride, according to him, pride is a bright crown that has always been something sweet to nations. They felt proud of their power, empire and resources. So what poet is saying here, they were, so those empires which were now destroyed, which their glory to decay, so now they, the reason was they were proud of their material things. Okay, they were proud of their swords or power. Okay, that is why they were destroyed. So what he is saying here, he, that has always been something sweet to the nation. They felt proud of their power, empire and resources. However, pride is not everlasting, right? Power is not everlasting. All right, very important line. God doesn't like it, and hence those who felt proud of themselves and their possessions were brought down to ashes at his feet. Pride is also not something that makes a nation great. Okay, very important thing. Now fifth, not gold but only men can make a people great and strong. Men who for truth and honor's sake stand fast and suffer long. Very important thing here. So in fifth stanza, what is given? So bit a rhyming scheme is same. Okay, A B in all stanzas. Okay, A B. All right. Now, according to the poet, it is not materialistic thing, but men who can make a nation great and strong. Okay, so who can make a nation great and strong? These are the men. All right. These are the men who stand and suffer for the sake of truth and honor. Thus, a country that has such men will be great and strong. All right. Now next, brave men who work while others sleep, who dare while others fly. They build a nation's pillar deep and lift them to the sky. Okay, rhyming scheme A B. Okay. Now those brave men work while others sleep. They dare to face problems when others run away. All right. So they are having that much. That much strength in themselves that at the situation others just run away, they just face those problems. According to the poet, these are the only people who make the foundation of a nation strong and take their progress to the skies. Thus, the nation's strength is great men, and they are what make a nation great and strong. So, a nation's strength, great men. Okay, these are the great men who can face the problem. Okay, so what is a nation's strength? Great men, those who can face the problem. All right, so this is about this poem. Okay, now let's see about William Ralph Emerson, the poet. He was born in the year 1839 and was died in the year 1917. He was an architect. He was the second cousin of Ralph Waldo Emerson. He designed several iconic buildings in the United States. All right. So here you can see the words meaning abiding. It is an adjective lasting a long time. Okay. Or enduring. Okay. Luster, the shining quality of something, that is luster. All right. Luster. T will be silent. Luster. All right. So this is the explanation of this poem. All right, now I want everybody to write the summary, all right, and send that to me. Okay, and in my next video I'll upload the question answer part of this poem. Okay, till the time just write the summary and send that to me. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Have a good day. Thank you.